Simon & Schuster Audio presents Zara's Rules for Living Your Best Life by Hena Khan, read by Subhadra Newton. To my inspiring young friend Zara. Chapter 1.
How about a marble roller coaster? Naomi suggests from her stool, where she's swinging her legs back and forth.
Yes, Zayd cheers, before suddenly frowning and adding, Wait, what's that?
We can't help but laugh at my little brother, who has snuck into our clubhouse to listen to our conversation. Again.
It's a roller coaster for a marble, Naomi explains. You use stuff like foam and cardboard and make loops and hills to see how far you can get the marble to go.
I ponder this as I bite into a sugar cookie, one of the snacks Naomi brought for us today. A marble roller coaster sounds less exciting than a real one, but it could still be fun to make. And if it turns out well, we could add it to the Brisk River Book of Neighborhood Records under Most Amazing Marble Roller Coaster.
Let's add it to the list, I say.
Our list of things to do over spring break is getting long already. Yesterday, Jade added weaving friendship bracelets out of recycled plastic. Gloria wants to make homemade paletas, frozen fruity treats that she insists are better than flavored ice sticks. Alan said he's going to organize an epic Easter egg hunt. That gave Jade the idea to add decorating eggs to the list. And since Zayd is still deciding what he wants us all to do together over break, I left the space for number 5 blank for him. Melvin is traveling to Korea over break, so his ideas for things to do aren't on the list. And although Naomi's brother Michael hasn't come up with any suggestions yet, I know he'll have something to say about everything we do. He's in 8th grade already and has lots of opinions. I write marble roller coaster on the whiteboard and stand back to admire the list. There's no way this isn't going to be the best spring break ever. None of the kids on our street could complain that we aren't doing something that they want. We've included everyone, which is the number 1 neighborhood rule for having fun. And all the activities sound like they could be a good and even delicious time.
What supplies do we need? Naomi asks. Let's make sure we get everything ahead of time. We don't want another piñata situation.
I groan. Last summer, we made a huge batch of glue mixture to craft a homemade piñata shaped like a strawberry. We followed step-by-step instructions from a video on YouTube. But since we didn't have any balloons, we used an old beach ball and layered the newspaper, glue, and tissue on top of it. It looked seriously amazing when we were finished. You're supposed to pop the balloon and take it out of the piñata when the glue is dry, and then you could put the candy inside. But the beach ball wouldn't pop no matter what we did, so we couldn't get to that step. Michael ended up shaking the bag of candy out around the yard instead. The candy flew everywhere, and everyone dove onto the grass and fought each other for it. Months later, Melvin found a mini Tootsie Pop over by his garage.
We'll get all the things we need, I promise.
It's not that much, except for maybe the roller coaster foam, and the eggs, and popsicle sticks, but we still have a few days before break.
I'll ask my mom if she can help us, Naomi offers.
I already know that Mrs. Goldstein is ready to help. She has an entire cabinet full of crafting supplies. It's like she's just waiting for us to ask her for pipe cleaners or tissue paper or googly eyes. My mom's answer when I ask her for stuff is usually, check the garage. But you'd be surprised by all the useful things I've managed to dig out of there.
Let's ask her now, Naomi says. And I want to get a drink.
Let's go, Zayd, I tell my brother. Wipe up your crumbs, okay? The last thing we need is for Zayd to dirty up the clubhouse after we spent a whole hour spring cleaning it over the weekend. It's looking great now that we swept out all the dead leaves and grass, dusted it, and wiped down the stools. We've got the whiteboard and our book of records in there, along with tennis balls and jump ropes. After our stools and a tiny tray table for snacks, there's not much room for anything else. But it's still the perfect place to make plans, hide out, and take a break from the sun.
and it was one of Naomi's best ideas ever to turn the old tool shed in her backyard into our fun-making headquarters.
"Hey, Mom,"
Naomi asks as we head into her house and Zayd trots back across the street to our house.
"Can you help us with supplies?"
"For what, honey?" Mrs. Goldstein asks. She's in the kitchen chopping up herbs and throwing them into a bowl.
"For all the activities we plan for spring break," Naomi explains. "We need foam, popsicle sticks, tape, and what else was there, Zara?"
"Oh dear," Mrs. Goldstein puts down her knife. "I thought I told you I signed you up for camp this break."
"What? You didn't tell me," Naomi says. "Which camp?"
We look at each other in surprise, and Naomi raises her eyebrows in a way that I know means I have no idea what's going on. "The temple is offering a day camp, so I signed you and Michael up," Mrs. Goldstein explains.
"Do I have to go?" Naomi pleads. "Zara and I already have the whole week planned out. We came up with a long list of things to do with everybody."
"I've already paid for it," Mrs. Goldstein says, shaking her head as she wipes her hands on a dish towel. "So yes, I'm afraid you do have to go. And besides, you'll like it. Your friends from Hebrew school will be there."
"Okay,"
Naomi says, even as her shoulders droop.
"Come on, Zara."
Naomi grabs my hand and we walk into the family room and sit down together on our sofa in stunned silence.
"Sorry," she finally whispers to me. "I had no idea."
"It's okay," I whisper back, even though my throat tightens as I speak. Spring break won't be the same without Naomi.
Chapter 2. Mama is scowling at the television while watching the news, so I wait for a commercial before asking my question.
"Can I go to Har Shalom spring break camp?"
"Where?" Mama replies, turning her full attention to me.
"Naomi's going, and we had so many things we planned to do over break, so I thought maybe I'll just go to camp with her instead because she said that it's really great and that it has all this..."
"Slow down." Mama holds up her hands like she does when she wants me to take a breath and stop speaking. I pause. "You want to go to camp at the synagogue?" Mama asks.
"Yeah, with Naomi. I mean, I know it's probably mostly for Jewish kids, but remember when you said Muslims are so much like Jewish people when we were at Michael's bar mitzvah?"
"Yes, I remember," Mama says.
"So then it'll be okay for me to go, right?"
I continue. Mama makes a sound that's half cough, half laugh. "Listen, I'm sure the folks at Har Shalom would welcome you at the camp, but I already made plans for break," she finally says.
"You did?"
I ask. Mama didn't tell me about any plans.
"That must be because it's a surprise.
Maybe we're going on a trip. We've been talking about driving to the beach for a while. That's got to be it." My mother pats the seat next to her, like she does whenever she has big news. I begin to make a mental list of the items I'm going to pack for the beach. I can't forget to bring my new hat with the tiny pineapples all over it, and my swimming shoes if I can find them. I should probably make up some games for the car ride, so Zayd doesn't annoy us the whole time. "I'm going to be tied up with a training at the office, and your father is extra busy with a proposal, so I thought you and Zayd could spend the week with Naano and Nana Abu," Mama continues.
"Hold on. What? Does that mean we're not going to the beach?" I ask.
"No, Zara," Mama sighs. "Not the beach. You two are on spring break, but Baba and I still have work. Don't worry, your grandparents are excited to take care of you two and spend the week with you, especially now that Nana Abu is retired and has more free time, remember?" She says it like I could have already forgotten the special dinner to celebrate Nana Abu's retirement last week. Even though it was a party, it seemed to make him happy and sad at the same time. He worked at the same company for 37 years, and now he won't be going there or seeing his coworkers anymore. It would be better to go on a vacation, I say. Zayd, who somehow always appears whenever there's big news, rushes into the room.
Where are we going?
He asks, breathless. Not to the beach, I mutter.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.